So here I have the equation written, and I've written it both ways, just the original, the way using the gradient imagery dot product way, or in the algebraic way. Question: how many unknowns and how many equations per pixel? The number of unknowns is easy. What was I trying to solve for? U and V, right? U and V is which way is this point moving? Great. How many equations? Well, yes, there are two equations up there, but they're the same equation. I have two unknowns, but only one equation per pixel. This should bother you, right? It's very hard to solve things that you've got twice as many unknowns as you have equations. Because remember, I have a different U and V possibly for every pixel. So I've got two times the number of pixels unknowns, and I've got one equation per pixel, two times the number of pixels. What's going on here? So intuitively, we can think about what this constraint means as follows. The component of UV that's in the direction of the gradient, that's what we can measure, right? That amount will tell us how much the image will change. That's why that's the amount of IT, or I sub T, the derivative, right? So what this is saying is if this is the direction of our gradient as indicated here, right? Here, suppose this is my real UV right there. Well, any other UV that has a component of the same amount in the direction, but I've got a U prime V prime, that's in an extra component that's parallel to the edge, all right? And this new vector here, which was the original U V plus U prime V prime, it has the same amount perpendicular to the edge in the direction of the gradient, but a different amount along the edge. Remember when we were doing corner finding and we put up a thing and we said, well, if you slide it up and down, if your little patch is on the edge of the black square, if we slide it up and down, we can't tell at all. We can only tell how much is being moved perpendicular to the edge. That's what's going on here. Locally, we can only tell the amount of motion that is perpendicular to the edge in a little area. When you think about this little area, you can think of it like looking through a little hole. Remember from our talk about cameras that that's called an aperture. And this general problem, this is called the aperture problem.